All right, B. Who are you and what's your game?
The majority party is allowed to dictate the results of contested elections. We can scarcely call ourselves free.
An exception.
If we yield up our rights bit by bit to the cause, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
This is so like you, Gladstone. You would rather throw your body upon the gears of progress than surrender one iota of power.
By God, Disraeli, you are a fool. I'll not stand idly by and watch you drag parliamentary privilege through the muck.
No, certainly not.
Oh,
you'd
yes.
rather return us to the yoke of tyranny.
Lord Cardigan.
Perhaps while we're at it, Mr. Gladstone, we could
that
reveal Magna Carta
the
and return
the
crown
to
the bloody
status, sir.
How
now,
dare you, sir?
If the Parliament would only...
Merely
because
I do not wish to see government placed in the hands of judges, you would make these slanderous accusations? I'll not stand for it!
Then I shall obviate the requirement. Good evening, sir.
What the devil? Oh, blimey! B, I presume.
Thank you.
pleasure to meet you. B.
B! My name's Herbert!
And why are you following the Prime Minister?
It's just a job, sir! Some old bloke paid me to...
Smug bastard.
Well, I was born in Crawley, but that's by the by. Who are you working for?
Oh, I never got his name. Old chap, big moustache, wore some kind of uniform. Who's ours, maybe?
What's his game?
Please, you'll kill me.
And a three-story drop will shatter your legs and send you to the workhouse. Difference is you can run from him.
Tomorrow! Oh, my lads are going to attack the Prime Minister's carriage on the way to Parliament.
Perfect.
Oh!
So much for the house call. We'll have to find a way into that carriage.
Meaning of this? Who the devil are you?
Prime Minister, I'm your new bodyguard, Jacob Frye.
I wasn't informed of any new bodyguard. Who's your commanding officer?
Let the boy speak, Dizzy.
Madam, apologies. But we've learned of a threat on your life. And the Met thought it best to move quickly.
Threat? What sort of threat?
That sort. If you excuse me a moment.
So fast, Your Excellency.
Hey! Get back here with that Prime Minister!
Steady on. Walk on, girl.
For this.
Thank you. What do you intend to do about Gladstone, young man?
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough and ready sort of fellow, Mr. Frye.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Frye.
But I...
Good day, Mr. Frye!
Coming alive.
I'm afraid I must cancel our engagement. The lawn is crawling with scandal-hunting journalists, and I simply cannot be seen in the company of someone so...
I'll see them off. You follow along when it's clear.
Yes, yes. Be gentle, won't you? The press are notoriously touchy about any violence to their person.
Ha ha ha. I'll barely ruffle a hair on their heads.
Shh, Desmond.
So we did.
young man. Dizzy ought to keep you on to deal with the liberals. Now.
In the car, that's it's the Prime Minister's wife.
I really must not be seen here, Mr. Fry.
Mrs. Disraeli! Mrs. Disraeli! Any comment on the assassination attempt?
Do be cautious!
Keep moving. Walk on, girl. Easy, girl. Easy. That's a girl. Who's a good horse? You are. Let's go. That's a girl. Easy. Is your dog quite all right?
Oh, Desmond's fine. He's just not overfond of strangers. Or cats. This gentleman is a... Oh, what was it? Yes, a costermonger, of all things. Remarkable how the working classes occupy themselves, isn't it?
Very industrious, I'm sure. Shall we go?
zone.
There's some odd bods in this town.
Mr. Frye, look at those two.
Yes, they seem to be,
I've been married twice, Mr. Frye. I'm fully aware of what they're doing. God bless them. What sort of meat is that man selling?
Best not to ask.
Why? Is it something dreadful? Is it rat?
I don't mean to be indelicate, given the present company, but another name for it is Bow Wow Mutton.
Here we are. The old what?
So, this is a pint, is it? Remarkable.
Nice doggy.
Good boy, Desmond. Hand over the mutt.
You'll change your tune when me and my friends find you.
Now then, Desmond, to get you back to your mistress, whom I've just left entirely unattended in one of London's most dangerous pubs.
Told your father how you felt about him. How was he supposed to know?
I never thought of it that way. I suppose deep down we all just want to be loved.
Just so. Here, have a sweetie. Oh, Desmond and Mr. Frye, I'd like you to meet... Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
John the Tosser.
Charmed. I think we better get you home.
Right you are, Mr. Frye. Come along, Desmond.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the dog walker.
Now, let's not do something we'll regret.
Doing fine, good.
Well, I must thank you for a most energetic and enlightening evening, Mr. Frye.
No, thank you. Perhaps now you might tell me about the man in the Hussar's uniform.
Quite right. Lord Cardigan is the gentleman you seek. Tiresome. Always blathering on about his military adventures.
Do you know where I might find him for a private conversation?
I do indeed. He's in town now, as it happens, campaigning against the Corrupt Practices Bill. Perhaps you could catch him in the Palace of Westminster.
Your stop, madam.
My stop? How delightful. Thank you. Thank you for a splendid evening, Mr. Frye. I shall be sure to speak highly of you to Dizzy. Oh, yes.
Please tell me again where we are going.
I found a letter from the Prince Consort among Lucy Thorne's research, marked with the same insignia as your key, dated 1847.
1847?
The same year the Prince began renovations to Buckingham Palace.
You think he added a vault for the Shroud?
And since there is no map of the palace with the room marked Secret Vault...
Your Highness, may I present Miss Evie Frye. Miss Frye, Maharaja Duleep Singh.
A pleasure, Your Highness.
My friend, the plans you asked for have been removed.
Removed? By whom?
Crawford Starrick, or someone employed by him. Yes, I thought you might recognize the name. I know where they are, but it is heavily guarded.
That part will not be a problem.
I thought not.
We're going to need a plan.
I can provide a distraction for the guards while you find a safe way inside.
Oh, really?
For you, Evie? Certainly.
Well, once I'm inside, I'll find someone who knows where the papers are stored.
And we will meet back on the train.
Be careful. That's not them. Nothing here. No. Looks like I have to ask someone where the plans are.
Those damned assassins.
Thank you.
Miss, I don't know where they've taken him.
Taken who?
The man, dressed like you. The guards dragged him off.
Henry, the plans you stole, where are they?
I don't know anything about that.
The plans, the mission. Some of Clara's children.
They took Mr. Henry. We couldn't stop them.
I bit one of them good, though.
They dragged him off in a red carriage.
They won't get far, though. One wheel looked like it was about ready to fall off. You can see the cart tracks. It looks all wobbly-like.
Walk on, girl.
That cart's been run off the road. They must be driving quickly. They're knocking people over, too. And destruction of public property. I must be on the right track.
Atta girl. Whoa! There you go.
That must be the carriage. Found you. Now to find Henry.
That's it. About the carriage, but there's been some strange happenings around here today. All kinds of unsavory types wandering around, armed to the teeth. I don't like it one bit.
I saw them dragging someone out of the carriage after the wheel fell off. They said he'd hit his head. Not sure why they needed to take him to the church, but that's where they went.
I've seen around here. Carried him into the churchyard. Maybe he wanted a quiet place to sleep it off.
I could have sworn I'd locked this gate. This is supposed to be locked. Bloody urchins opened it again, no doubt.
We have a problem! I am...
Henry.
Is he coming around?
I don't know. We knocked him around pretty good. Wouldn't be surprised if it took a while.
Well, I hope you haven't addled his brain.
He's an assassin. How much more addled could he get?
Someone to move the architectural plans. Do you have them?
Did they hurt you?
I'm fine.
Let's go.
What about the plans?
The plans are lost.
I'm sorry.
Just concentrate on escaping, please. Get Miss Nightingale to look at that. I must find the vault before Starrick secures the shroud.
We'll talk to the Maharaja again.
I will talk to the Maharaja. You will get your head looked at.
I'm sorry my capture hasn't done your plans.
You'd be safer on the train.
Even if you find the vault, you can't just walk into Buckingham Palace alone.
I won't be alone. I'll see you back at the train, Mr. Green.
Oh.
Thank you.